I'm sitting here waiting for a video to render, and I'm just looking through Craigslist, and it's like a fucking gold mine on here today. Like, you got a fucking DDR machine, 2 grand. I mean, it's a lot of money, but you know, still a full arcade machine. There's a pinball game for a grand. There's a TRS-80 on here. That's tempting. $75 is not bad. Looks like it's in good shape too. That is very tempting. And like $90 PS3, that's not terrible. Chrono Trigger, Castlevania, Mario RPG, $200 all four. That's a little below retail. Steam Link, $15. A whole bunch of Sega stuff. What did I see a few minutes ago when I was fucking Zelda test cart? I mean, they want $2,500 for it, but whoever this dude is in Wakefield, it looks like, I think they're just selling everything they got. I'm always really sketchy on these yellow Zelda test carts because I don't know why they exist. I mean, I get that there's test carts for NES games. You know, like the color test, the power supply test, all that, you know, whatever crap they do. But what was the point of the Zelda test cart? Was it to make sure the system let you save? I mean, the system doesn't do it saving. Saving was a function of the battery inside. So how are you really testing the console when it's the cart that more than likely is flawed? Unless it's the system's inability to let it save? I don't know. That's really stretching. I just don't know why that cart existed. Look at Xbox One Kinect. 20, that's a good deal. $20 for that. That's pretty fair. You see the adapter now if you have the 1S like I have. So I don't know. I just want to throw that out there. Just some bizarre prices on stuff. So, not bizarre, but just really good stuff today. So whatever.